Welcome to Narayana Online Classes. Today we are going to discuss a topic called rational numbers of class 6. Let's discuss some of the questions on it. For example, what is a rational number? Any number which can be expressed as a p by q form, where p and q are integers and where q is not equal to 0. First example is minus 4 by 7 a rational number? Is minus 4 by 7 a rational number? So how to identify the given number is a rational number or not? You see this, minus 4 by 7 is given. Here minus 4 is an integer or not? Yes, minus 4 is an integer. And if you see the denominator, 7 is an integer or not? Yes, 7 is also an integer. So according to the definition, any number which is in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0, is a rational number. Therefore, minus 4 is an integer, 7 is an integer, and denominator is not equal to 0, therefore it is a rational number. Therefore, minus 4 by 7 is a rational number. Next, let's see one more question. Is 7 by 8 a fraction or a rational number? Or both? To solve this question, let's go theoretically. So what is the difference between fraction and rational number? So both looks like fraction means it can be expressed in the form of a by b, where a and b are natural numbers. A comma b belongs to natural numbers. That means both numerator and denominator are positive. When it comes to rational numbers, it is expressed in the form of p by q, where p comma q belongs to integers and q is not equal to 0, right, or z. So what is the difference between fraction and rational number? All the fractions are rational numbers, but all the rational numbers are not fractions. The reason is, here p and q are integers. Integers can be negative also, but whereas natural numbers cannot be negative. Therefore, all the rational numbers cannot be fractions, but all the fractions are rational numbers. Now, coming to the question, 7 by 8, yes, I know. See, 7 is a natural number, 8 is also a natural number. And both are in the form, it is in the form of a by b. Therefore, it is a fraction. And next, 7 by 8. 7 is an integer and 8 is also an integer. Therefore, it is in the form of p by 2. Therefore, it is a rational number. Or instead of explaining like this, you can say in another way, as all the fractions are rational numbers, so 7 by 8 is also a rational number. Therefore, 7 by 8 is both fraction as well as rational. This is how we come to the solution. Next, coming to the third question. Let's see one more example on this. Express 77 by 245 a in the standard form of a rational number. So what is the standard form of a rational number? So any number which is in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0, is called as rational number. Then what is the standard form? Both numerator and denominator should have HCF, their HCF should be 1. So let us see whether their HCF is 1 or not. Or let's see whether we can simplify them or not. See, both 77 and 245 are divisible by 7. That means they have a common factor 7. Then they are not in the form of, then they are not in standard form. So let's reduce it to the simplest form. 7 elements, 7, 35. Therefore, 77 by 245 is equal to 11 by 35. So this is the standard form of a rational number. 77 by 245 is a rational number. But to reduce it to standard form, we need to see whether both numerator and denominator have any other common factor 1 other than 1. If they don't have any other common factor other than 1, then they are in standard form. Otherwise, we need to reduce it to simplest form. Let's see one more example. Is 0 a rational number? Is 0 a rational number? Yes, 0 is a rational number. The reason is 0 can be written as 0 by 1 or 0 by 2 or 0 by 10, anything you can write. The reason is, when you divide 0 with any other number other than 0, it gives you 0 again. So I can express 0 as 0 by 1 or 0 by 2 or 0 by 10 or 0 by 100, anything you can write. See, 0 is the numerator. One is the denominator. Both 0 and 1 are integers. 0 and 1 are integers. And denominator is not equal to 0. Therefore, it is in the form of rational number. Therefore, 0 is a rational number. Similarly, we can take other examples and we can discuss whether they are rational numbers or not. Hope you understood this session. Thank you. Have a nice day.